can see how the first five have been for the Lakers.
Andrew, nobody there over the top of Nene.
It didn't hurt any less.
Kobe losing Nene. And will he get the roll? Yes.
I think he knew was how to get to the front of the rim, and Kobe gave him that pass and played above the rim. The easiest deuce of the evening.
And let's see what they do over the next 6.5 minutes. Kobe. Nice to have that weapon.
Usually get the job done. But the one thing the Lakers want to try to get done is more easy opportunities like Kobe received from Powell on one case, because Kobe can get his own. And you can get him some easy ones. He just really put the defense in a bad way. That last shot there, that's the one that's not easy.
As he hit the deck. Now on the handoff, Ariza sets up Gasol. He wanted to reverse, they'll take that.
A lot of guys watch the physical play of the bigs on the interior.
Bad pass, Kobe, the distance. Now both big men get a touch. Andrew Bynum. And stayed with it.
A foul. You know, defense, again, bad angle pass. Kobe with the pick. Takes it down for the easy deuce. Runs his point total.
Well, he changed it, but then rebounded.
Yeah, and we've talked about it. As Ariza filling it up inside the arc.
And Andrew Bynum coming alive in this ball game for sure, whether it's on the defensive end or cleaning up misses. I mean, the guy plays like a 7-footer, real long, absorbing contact from big, strong Nene. Didn't bother Andrew on his last basket. That's a nice-looking play by
Andrew Bynum. Sat down. Lamar coming back into the game. Kobe sizing things up. He's been on since the beginning tonight. How good it's been.
Well, Kobe's last jumper, the Carl's Jr. Exmo shows it perfectly. Hands up together, down together, and splash.
It's a 19-point Laker lead. And Kobe, like a layup.
Lakers up 88-67, and in case you missed it, our Toyota game reset. You know, Kobe's been the guy from the start, leading all scorers with 29. One of his running mates, Paul Gasol, is having a decent game. 5 out of 9 from the field for 12 points. And Andrew Bynum getting some touches and making the most of it. 6 out of 8 from the field. You got to get into your offense sooner, especially when Kobe's not on the floor, because Kobe's the one guy that can create his own.
Lamar blocking away.
You know, the last one of the trips down is Lamar blocking the shot of J.R. Smith. And then the ball just bounces around, and finally the Lakers pick it up. But the long arm of Lamar Odom.
Back up. Trevor Ariza saw it coming. Another steal.
Trevor sees everything. That man's anticipation is just beautiful.
Lamar's got the mismatch if they want to go inside. Sasha, this time, the machine wasn't going to stop, was it? Blazer, blocked by Andrew. That's his first block of the game, believe it or not. Best thing that could happen to the Lakers. Nuggets using a lot of the shot clock. And Farmar coming up with a steal. Jordan with Sasha uses him as a decoy.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Not close, but Ariza.
Gotta
go back up. Shot clock. And will it get to the rim? Not only will it get to the rim, how about going in? An afterthought.
It's like Phil Jackson drew up that last three-pointer. Trevor looks up, sees the clock after hearing the crowd scream, just fires away and, you know, pretends like, hey, I do this all the time. That's what I like to see. You don't have to celebrate after everything you do.
Along with J.R.'s. That almost went down from that range. Plays it. Blocked away. Josh Powell never quits. Extra pass. And Josh Powell set it up for Luke Walton.
With Chauncey Billups, they were 7-1, but you handled this team pretty easy.
Well, it's just about getting their rhythm a little bit. You know, they're a team that's trying to search for a new identity right now. And you know, they've been playing very well as of late, but we got them.
Hyundai dealers, don't go anywhere.